बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, अस्सलामुअलैकुम। दिस इज़ फेमिला चन्ना, लेक्चरर जूलॉजी फ्रॉम गवर्नमेंट गर्ल्स डिग्री कॉलेज मोरो। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिलीवर अ लेक्चर अबाउट फाइलम पोरीफेरा एंड नाइडेरिया फ्रॉम सब्जेक्ट बायोलॉजी फर्स्ट ईयर। कॉन्टेंट्स ऑफ टुडेज लेक्चर: जनरल करेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ फाइलम पोरीफेरा, क्लासेज ऑफ फाइलम पोरीफेरा, questions related with phylum Porifera, self-evaluation test about phylum Porifera, general characteristics of phylum Cnidaria, classes of phylum Cnidaria, self-evaluation test in the form of MCQs about phylum Cnidaria. Let's start a lecture about the Porifera. Do you know the word Porifera is taken from a Greek word porous, it means pores or holes, and ferritin means to bear, which means organisms which bear pores or hole on its body is known as Porifera. In simple, pore-bearing animals is known as Porifera. About 5,000 species of Poriferans found around the world. Due to presence of holes or pores all over the body, there is a canal system which help in circulating water throughout the body to bring in a food and oxygen. In this figure, these pores are showing. These pores are known as ostia, and the number of the ostia is millions. And here these are the osculum through which the excess of water is removed out. And characteristics of phylum Porifera: the animal of phylum Porifera are sessile, it means they are not able to move. They are sedentary, it means those which are not able to move, it means non-motile animals, and they are attached with some solid support or fixed something. They are marine mostly, it means they are live in a sea water and ocean water. Except one group or family name is Spongylidae. They are commonly known as sponges. Why they are known as sponges? Because their body is have a millions of pores, therefore they are like a sponge, therefore known as sponges. The body of Poriferans is covered with a hard outside layer of skeleton that shown in this figure. A skeleton is made up of calcareous or calcium carbonate or silicaceous spicules, means silica or spongin fiber, or both of them. Some best known example of Poriferans shown in this figure. General characteristics of phylum Porifera: they have two main type of pores present in Poriferans. Ostia, they are known as incurrent pores. Why they are known as incurrent pores? Because through which the water is entered towards the body of Poriferans, therefore is known as incurrent pores. And osculum, they are known as excurrent pores. Why? Because through which undigested food or excess amount of water is removed out from the any Poriferans, therefore is known as excurrent pores. Ostia found in the millions number, but osculum is found in 1 to 3 number. Mostly sponges are filter feeder. Why they are filter feeder? Because they are sessile and sedentary, and therefore they are filter feeders, and they are depend on the minerals of the water and the debris of some microorganisms. Sponges can reproduce asexually by budding and fragmentation. Sponges are mostly hermaphrodite. Hermaphrodite means those animals which have one individual have present both sexes is known as hermaphrodite. Sponges are produced by also gemmule formation, and larva of sponges is known as amphiblastula. At the larval stage they are able to move, but about adult state they will become stationary or sessile. In Poriferans, they have a four main type of cells found: pinococyte cells, these are epidermal cells, and they are found in sponges only. They line the outer surface of Poriferans. Canocyte cells, these are flagellated cells, line the inner hollow cavity of the spongocoel. Amebocyte cells, they occupy the inner layer along with hardened structure known as spicules, and they form exoskeleton. Porocytes, these cells are found in the outer layer of sponges. They are pore-forming cells. Canal system of Porifera: a cone type. It is a very simplest type, very small tube-shaped sponges. Large central cavity, spongocoel, in via small opening called ostia, out through the single osculum. Second type is cyclone type. It is taken from a cone pattern by folding a mold, branching, has incurrent canals, and a side passage still have main spongocoel, single osculum. Lecon type, Most complex consists of many small flagellated chambers, no longer a central spongocele, but almost unlimited ability for sponges to grow in size. Generally larger colonial forms, each mass has its own osculum in current and excurrent canals. Type of sponges shown in this figure and their examples also shown in this figure. Classes of phylum Porifera according to the first year syllabus of biology. Class Calcicereus is also known as Calcicerea. These are the small waist shaped permeative group. They are mostly drape colored. A few are in a yellow, red, green color found. All are marine, especially shallow water. Show all three types of canal system found in Calcicereus. Sponges, mostly as cone canals, are found in it. Spicules are made up of calcium carbonate. Needle shaped are 3 or 4 rayed. Second class is also known as glass sponges, and their name is Hexacatylida. They are all are marine, mostly deep colder water. Body often cylindrical or funnel shaped. Most are waist like or tubular, 7 to 10 cm to 1 m tall, all with silicaceous spicules. 6 rays are long hair like fiberglass, usually with large spongocele and large osculum, in which the cicone and helicone canal system is found. A cone type is not found in glass sponges. Third class is class Demospongia, is known as Spongian sponges. It is the largest class of phylum Porifera. 90% of living species of Poriferans belong to this Demospongia class. Most diverse group, including most large sponges, including common bath sponge. Mostly they are marine in a water. One small family live in a fresh water. It is known as Spongelidae family. They are sponges, spicules and a silica, but they haven't 6 rays. They are spongin fibers are both, some tall and a finger like, some are include one group are boring sponges, grow into shells and a carrels. Some examples of sponges are shown in this figure: Spongelae, Cycone, Euplectila. Questions: why Porifera is known as sponges? Answer is that due to millions of pores on the body of sponges, therefore is known as sponges. Why sponges have not tissue organization? Because sponges are multicellular, but their cells are loosely bounded, therefore no tissue organization. Third question is, which family of Porifera found in a fresh water? Answer is family Spongelidae. An example is Spongela. Self-evaluation test about phylum Porifera MCQs. These are for students. Solve these questions. Now phylum Coelenterata or phylum Cnidaria. They have a 9,000 species according to the first year syllabus. They are general characteristics of phylum Cnidaria shown in this figure. They are commonly known as Coelenterata. Why they are known as Coelenterata? Because with hollow and drawn is therefore known as Coelenterata. They all are aquatic. Majority of them are marine, where some live in a fresh water. They are radially symmetrical. What do you mean by radially symmetrical? Means those animals which body divide into 2 equal halves with main axis is known as radially symmetrical. And they are diploblastic. What do you mean by diploblastic? It means di means 2, blast means layer. It means those animals which have a 2 body layers, ectoderm, outer layer, and endoderm, inner layer of the body, is known as diploblastic animals. Coelenterata act as a radiometry gut open into exterior, which serve as a mouth and anus. The cnidarians have no respiratory, excretory, circulatory system. All cnidarians are mostly carnivorous in nature, and carnivorous animals mostly are the predators. They paralyze or kill their prey with the help of special stinging cells. They are known as cnidocytes. Due to these cnidocytes' presence, Coelenterata is known as Cnidaria also. Cnidarians are diploblastic. In between these both 2 layers, ectoderm, endoderm, the non-cellular gelatinaceous mass are present. These are known as mesogelia. Polyps. The 2 forms of the cnidarians found. polyps and medusa. They are polyps are the cylindrical with mouth and a tentacle situated at the point. Their examples are hydra and sea anemone. Medusa, they are umbrella shaped whose mouth and tentacles are open on the lower surface. Examples are jellyfish. Polyps, they are shown in this figure. They are polyps and their tentacles are upper surface. These are the medusa. Their tentacles are present in the lower surface and they are the umbrella shaped medusa. Some differences between polyps and medusa show in this table. Polyps usually sessile. Medusa mostly are mobile or motile. Sessile means those which are not able to move. And motile are those which are able to move from one place to another place like a jellyfish. Polyps are vase shape or cylindrical shape. Medusa are bell shape or umbrella in shape. Polyps are mesogelia is a very thin. But in a medusa, mesogelia is a very thick. Mesogelia is a layer between two ectoderm and endoderm layers. It is non-cellular mass is known as mesogelia. In polyps, mouth at the upper surface, but in medusa, mouth at the lower surface of the body. In polyps, tentacles occurs around the mouth, but in medusa, tentacles occurs along edges of the umbrella-shaped body. Tentacle in polyps, they are the solitary or colonial. Solitary means those animals which live in single is known as solitary. Colonial means animals live in a group form or in a colonial form is known as colonial animals. Medusa always solitary. It means medusa live in single. Polyps sometimes they build hard or soft corals, but medusa never build any skeletal corals. Polyps examples are corals, hydra. Medusa examples are jellyfish. Alternation of generation. The typical cnidarian's life cycle involves both sexual and asexual reproduction. Asexual polyps produce male or female medusa, which is a result of sexual reproduction from zygote. A bilateral symmetrical larva known as a planula larva. Name of cnidarian's larva is planula larva. That is a very important MCQs. From that planula larva develop a zygote. The planula larva settle in location and a growth in an adult. Polyps then reproduce asexually to form medusa again. That phenomena and this process is known as producing asexual form by sexual form and vice versa. That is known as alternation of generation. In zygote transform into planula larva. The figure of alternation of generation shown in this. Polymorphism. The occurrence of a species in two or more body forms is called polymorphism. Word polymorphism comprises of two words. Poly means many, morph means form. It means one individual have a many forms found in the body and they are perform a different functions is known as also polymorphism. Now they have a gastrozoites. Gastrozoites they are take part in a food material. Gonozoites, they help in a reproductive zoites or they help in a reproduction. Dactylozoites, they are sensory zoites and protect animals. It means they are help in defense and offense. Is known example of hydrozoa is hydra. Class Cyphozoa, they are generally known as jellies. Their medusa stage is a very dominant, come in a variety of form, aggressive predators and can be dangerous to human being like a physilia. They are known as coral reefs. Fourth class, they are not mentioned in the first year syllabus, but I am mentioning this class Cubozoa, about 42 species, and some reference book have a 45 species of the Cubozoa are found. Mutacellular life cycle found in a Cubozoans. Their example is box jellies. Some characteristics of all the 8 classes of phylum Cnidaria, Hydrozoa, Cyphozoa, Cubozoa, Anthozoa found in this table. Read it and watch this table carefully. Some example of cnidarians are shown in this figure, like hydra, sea anemone, jellyfish, physalia. Self-evaluation test about phylum Cnidaria in the MCQs form. This test is for students, so solve it. Please share your feedback or comments. Thanks to all watching.